was this, when you first mentioned the project and it wasn't passing, we were working on something else, and you were saying, yeah, I think we need to make a, the next thing I'll be doing is try to make a building disappear. I think I have a couple of ideas. I first, when I thought of a building, I wouldn't have imagined the scale of the, like, and what it means to make something like that disappear then becomes very interesting and very different.
Yes, how to silence it in some way, or like,
yeah.
make it more quiet. It's like 111 meters long. And what you were saying, it's interesting that you can see it from very, very far, then it's like huge
read,
space,
yeah.
And just this building, then as you're approaching, there is no end to it on
left and right,
kind of like,
which is super, it's really, really rare. And to mute something where the whole surrounding is created to make it be as dominating or present, that's a very interesting challenge to do.
I was thinking about it also in terms of visual dominance, or more cognitive dominance, in the sense that what you, what is there or not, it is not there, it actually depends on what you expect or what you know about it. So to make it kind of invisible, to make it not there, it's supposed to just not show up in your memory. This was the question to think about. What does it mean within the larger process of cognition, of perception, of seeing it? So, I think the result which came out is that from the distance it is unseen, because it's kind of like gray, right?
Yes.
And from close, it starts to dissolve.
About this dissolving, because it's something that is hard to grasp when you were first mentioning it, and when you started showing the patterns, then this idea of how the frequencies work is quite interesting. And I think that's something nice also maybe to describe, like, what is the strategy that you use for dissolving? And how does that work?
And I started thinking about, like, how do you make it vibrate, dissolve, disappear, in the sense that you can't fix it visually, that you can't really figure out that it's there where it is, so that it's escaping your gaze in a way.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started to think about visual frequencies, which